The HTC U 11. This poor guy just went through one of my smartphone durability tests, and while most phones survive, this one didn't. His death is not in vain though, as this autopsy will show how to repair most everything inside the device, and how the pressure sensors for the HTC Touch Sense work since that feature is unique to this phone. And maybe we'll see if the transparent back glass panel is possible at the end of the video. Let's get started. Normally I would turn my phone off first, but I can't. Long pressing the home button doesn't work at this point either. Since the back glass panel is not embedded into the frame like on a Samsung, it is a relatively simple process to remove, as long as you don't slice too far into the device with your tools. After the glass is just barely too hot to touch comfortably, I'll slip my thin metal pry tool between the aluminum and the glass, and work my way around the edges. After the glass is up, I'll stick my green pry tool under the panel to keep it from re-adhering back to the frame again, and continue the cycle of heating the phone and slicing through the black adhesive. The black stuff is what helps keep your phone water resistant, so definitely don't trust your phone around water anymore after you've done any repairs. On the top black plastic panel, there are 5 little screws. I'm gonna spice things up a little during this video with some arrows I downloaded from graphic stock. They're doing a creator to creator challenge, and since video is a big part of what I do, I'm animating the PNG images I got from their website. There's a free 7-day trial waiting for you in the video description. Only now, after that panel is gone, can I turn off the phone by disconnecting the battery. There are no pull tabs on the battery, but at least the adhesive is pretty forgiving and will allow the battery to pop out from the frame without too much effort. Under the battery, we get our first glimpse of those pressure sensor ribbons on both sides of the phone. I'm taking special care not to puncture anything. The battery is a 3000 milliamp hour. I'll link these in the video description as soon as they become available. There's one screw holding on the motherboard in the bottom right hand corner. I'll set that off to the side, making sure to keep all the screws organized, and I'll pop that right pressure sensor ribbon connection off. It can unsnap like a little Lego, along with the other 3 ribbon cables along the bottom of the board, and the left pressure sensor. And lastly, the power and volume buttons can also unsnap like little Lego connections. There are 2 signal wires, a black and a white one, on the right side of the motherboard, and then for some reason, if your SIM card tray is still installed, you can remove it. It has the same rubber ring around the tip to help keep water out. And the motherboard is free to pull from the phone. The front and rear cameras snap off easy enough. It's really nice that HTC has finally organized their cabling inside the phone. If you watch my HTC 10 teardown, all of the different unorganized connections made repairing that phone a nightmare. This little guy on the left is a 16 megapixel front-facing camera, and the main rear camera has a 12 megapixel sensor with optical image stabilization. HTC opted not to include the OIS on the front-facing camera this year. Last year's HTC 10 was unique in having OIS on both cameras. Hopefully they go back to that with next year's phone. OIS is great for video. Down here at the bottom of the HTC U11 are 7 more screws. The adhesive around the center hole is the waterproofing for one of the 4 microphones this phone uses for its multi-directional audio recording. Removing that top plastic shield exposes 1 more screw, and finally the loudspeaker can be removed. It still has the black signal wire attached to it, and interestingly enough, it has the water-resistant mesh screen built into the speaker itself. With Samsung and iPhone devices, the waterproofing mesh is a separate unit, usually resting on the frame of the phone, so that's interesting. The charging port has 4 little Lego-style ribbon connections at the top. These are for the front capacitive buttons and for the extension ribbon to the main motherboard. As I was removing the charging port from the board, there is a ton of adhesive holding it into the frame, which definitely helps with the water resistance. The little metal circle thing you see is the vibrator motor, and there's also a clear rubber washer that rests around the USB-C port to keep the seal tight when it's all screwed in and held in place. The screen itself is replaceable. Using a lot of heat and patience, it can be removed just like we did with the back glass panel. It definitely won't survive the process, and is not as easy to replace as the Google Pixel, but it's still possible. I'll toss a link in the description for replacement screens. I'll have to get one for myself as soon as they're available. And now for the part that is completely unique to this phone. There is no other phone manufacturer that has ever attempted this before. Squeezable sensors built into the aluminum frame. The theory here is that the middle sides of the phone can be squeezed or flexed, and it can act as a trigger or button for different apps or features inside the phone, like the camera. It's not capacitive, because HTC says it can be used with gloves. After lifting that ribbon cable, there is a plastic bracket with grooves that run the signal wires. This comes off easy enough, and we get our first glimpse of the actual pressure sensor. It has 4 individual joints and is extremely well adhered to the frame. I don't imagine this can be removed without damaging it permanently. Flexible pressure sensors aren't a new thing. It's the same type of technology that we used inside of the old Nintendo Power Gloves back in the day. HTC is the first company to stick it inside a phone though, underneath metal. I assume that as the metal sides of the phone flex when the device is squeezed, the resistance changes along each of the joints, telling the phone that the grip has been triggered. With a more rigid frame, this feature probably wouldn't work. Huge thumbs up to HTC for trying something new and stepping out of the same rectangular box that most other cell phones are stuck in. The ideal, most sensitive squeeze points would be on the lower half of the phone, right where the sensors are located. Getting the phone back together is easy enough. I'll stick that rubber washer around the USB-C port and tuck it down into the frame, making sure no connectors are stuck underneath the board. And then after getting the four ribbon cables attached to the top of the board and one white wire cable snapped in, I'll toss on the loudspeaker, the top right screw, and the little plastic shield can go over the top of the whole component. And there's seven screws that hold it all in place. The flex sensor on the side rail goes in next with its little plastic guard. I have zero expectations of this functioning anymore in the future now that I've removed it, but I'll still put it back in anyway. The motherboard can get tucked down top first into the metal frame, and then all the little Lego-like connections along the bottom get clicked in. You'll feel them snap in onto the motherboard under your finger like a little Lego. The screen, the extension ribbon, and the pressure sensors on the side rails, along with the white and black wire cables on that right side. There are little metal guiding clips that help line the cables into the right spot. One more screw at the bottom of the motherboard, and lastly, the battery gets plopped back into place and plugged in. The plastic shield can go over the top of the motherboard with its five screws, and I can do a test run now by turning the phone on. And look, it's as good as new. Now the back glass panel will definitely need its own adhesive. I'll link some in the video description, but the HTC U11 back glass can indeed become clear. There is a plastic coating over the top of a super fine paint layer. It's a hard substance and scrapes off into shiny pixie dust pretty easy. It shouldn't need any paint remover like on the Galaxy S8. I'm not going to do the whole thing today because that would be like adding a paint job to a wrecked Ferrari. I'll see if I can fix the phone first before I continue any modifications. If you like creating stuff on the internet and want to try using GraphicStock's unlimited download of graphics, photos, and vectors, I put a free 7-day trial for you in the video description of this video. I'd love to see what you make, so tweet it over to me using the creator2creator hashtag. It saved me time today being able to jump on and grab some images instead of trying to create my own from scratch. Take a look at their library and see if anything will work for your projects. The link is in the description. Let me know if you have any questions in the comments or if you need any parts specific for your broken phone. And thanks a ton for watching. I'll see you around.